Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream.
I wasn't running to my full potential, and like Lambo told me, I have the body frame of Tarzan, but I run like Jake.
The whole time we spent in ETS, just during the off season,
they get a long run on us, well, on the dark side, talk like a Borat, and we'd say, I like, and we'd go and get them the next play. And
you know, the ETS, waking up at 5 in the morning and stuff, you know, coming to the high school.
Actually coming out on the TCF field, the reaction from the crowd, and then just the sheer awe of the stadium was just amazing.
Making it to the state, playing in the state tournament, because that was a great experience.
Eddie caught the ball and he threw it back, and the ball was flying in the air. And right as that happened, Lambo stepped in front of Carl, and we're all like, Lambo, watch out. And everyone's like, oh, watch out, Lambo. We all thought Lambo was going to die. Like, it was this huge thing. And then the ball hits Carl square in the nose, and we're like, oh, Carl. It was kind of funny. It gave Carl bloody nose and everything. I mean, Carl, I was feeling bad for you, but at the same time, I was on the ground laughing.
I would probably say my favorite memory was waking up at 6 a.m. during 2-a-days of practices. I like those 6 a.m. practices. I mean,
my touchdown, because, I don't know, it's my first varsity one and the only varsity one.
I was a little shocked at first. I was like, they're actually going to throw it to me. And I knew that, like, right when the play snapped, I was going to be wide open because the safety just went right by me. And I knew when the ball was in there, I was like, if I drop this catch, everyone is going to give me crap.
Standing with Brady, waiting as the final seconds tick down in the Minnetonka game.
I think playing at TCF.
My favorite memory was when Preston got that game-winning, what's it called? He like stole it, he like ripped it right from his hands and then ran for 6, and we won the game with like 10 seconds left.
For sure the Minnetonka game. First time our program has been in the state. 11 years or something.
When I was standing there on the sideline, and I'm not sure which coach it was, just ended up putting a headset on my head.
The school, like the culture of the school changed as a whole, and knowing that we were kind of the foundation and the base of that change.
It's definitely the 7-on-7 tournament at the U.
I think one of my favorite memories was probably the 40-yard gang we got going. There was like a group of like 7 or 8 of us. We just chanted the whole time.
We got to listen to some Taylor Swift and One Direction, Britney Spears, as we lifted and we always sang to the songs.
My favorite memory story was during ETS, we sang the Jukebox Hero in the weight room. That was just a blast because we all had fun and lifting.
My favorite memory's got to be beating Tonka to go to state. It was just a great experience.
We were just watching the Anoka film from the previous week, and I think it was Lambo who gave him the nickname Oompa Loompa.
It was the Anoka game, the first one. The second one he didn't talk. The first one, though, the nose guard, was like 4-2, and probably even less than that.
And I look across the line, and I'm just like staring at the little Oompa Loompa guy, and we're getting down in our stance, and I'm about ready to go, and all of a sudden I hear, "Do you have an everlasting gobstopper?" And simultaneously, every single one of us started laughing.
I just can't believe Schultz said that. It was so funny.
Yeah.
Solberg, one day before a game, before a game, he was going to the bathroom and dropped his mouth guard in the urinal, and he picked it up and washed it off and used it during the game.
I would probably just say put your heart into it.
Don't snap the ball over Lambo's head when he's already mad.
It goes by too quick.
We don't have any regrets, not one regret.
Put as much work as you can in.
Work as hard as you can, enjoy your time, it goes by way too quick.
It's like, put time into it and play. It's like, if you love it, go with it. It's like,
I would say just really like take it in. I mean, you don't really know how much time you have to play. Like,
I'd say go after everything as if that's gonna be your last.
Don't miss a day. I regret missing the days that I wasn't there. I wish I could have pushed myself harder. So push harder.
Keep working at it, but also support your older teammates, because you never know if you'll ever become in that position.
it didn't really like make sense. It didn't really fully click with me until after the season. But yeah, it goes by really quick. So
don't quit if you're not in varsity. Just keep going, because it's still a hell of a ride.
Work hard and don't quit.
Cherish these moments. It goes fast.
Enjoy every second of it. Even if it's practice, go hard and enjoy it.
Treat every moment like it's your last, because you don't know how fast it can be taken away from you.
Take advantage of the time, make most of it. Your senior year comes quick and it flies when it gets there, so.
I'm telling players it's never too late to start. I'd rather have no regrets than to end the season thinking about what if, you know.
Just go out every day and work hard.
Work hard, play hard, listen to Lambo.
One of the things I miss the most is my halftime speeches. You know, I had a good time doing those. You know. Mainly when we were kicking and receiving, I'd be like, oh, most of the time I'm receiving, I'd be like, oh, we're going to get the ball here. And then I'd say a bunch of swear words, and then I'd go on and just say how much we're going to dominate. And
the whole student section is pounding their feet, yelling, and then you get to come out, and everybody just yells, and you get to turn behind you, and you're just going to see all the fans cheering for you. It's
just every time you go on the field, it's kind of, you just get this big rush and everyone's screaming.
Being like, we have practice every day, and now you go from practice every day to nothing, and it kind of sucks. I feel a lifetime now.
The thing I'll miss the most, probably just playing under the Friday night lights.
Just being with the guys on and off the field.
How close the team was and how much, I got to see them every day through workouts and practices.
I am going to miss walking out onto that field and then singing the Star Spangled Banner.
I miss the fact that we had each other.
I'm going to miss playing with the boys the most, that's for sure.
Strapping it on every day and hitting people.
Hanging around with the guys and playing football.
The friendship you build with other guys, the lessons you learn through adversity and all that.
I'm going to miss the guys.
I'm going to miss the most, probably being with my best friends every single day.
Everything. I love the guys, I love the practices and everything. Just everything, yeah, just the game.
Being with the guys every day, getting up at, you know, 5 o'clock in the morning to go grind it out.
Playing on Friday nights, like playing four-year high school. Like,
I'm going to miss Mafia every Thursday and apostrophes, but
on Thursday for apostrophes and stuff with the team and just having like team time and stuff and like wearing my jersey to school and stuff, you know.
Friday nights are amazing, but also the camaraderie with my teammate.
Being a part of this family.
I'll definitely miss, you know, all the team bonding, singing in the weight room at ETS.
I would do anything for another year, for just another snap.
If I had to use one word to describe being a Crimson football player, it'd be very hard, I'd say that, first of all.
Heart. I have to say family again. Heart.
Commitment. There's so many things that go into it.
Pride.
Family.
Pride.
If I were to use one, though.
Family.
I think love.
Family. That we were family. There's no question about it whatsoever.
Pride.
I'd have to say shiesty.
Dedication.
Integrity.
Amazing.
Family, I guess.
Family.
Probably family.
Family.
Worthwhile.
Pride.
Family.
Family.
Warrior.
Sacrifice.
Probably incredible.
Dedication.
Family.
What we do for each other is based off of family. Our commitment is based off of family. We are just a big family.
I'd say honor.
Feeling my way through the darkness. Guided by a beating heart, I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream.